You guys, today we're going to be making homemade marinara sauce with some chicken parmesan. For a large batch of the marinara sauce, you're going to need 2 cans of tomato, crushed tomatoes, peeled tomatoes, however you want to do it. You can, if you get peeled tomatoes, you can always put it in the food processor and chop it up. You're going to need garlic, salt, olive oil, oregano, bay leaves, parsley flakes, thyme, basil, a medium onion, a large onion, a bottle of white wine, could be any flavor, Pinot Grigio, Cabernet, and you're gonna need a handheld can opener because the big cans are hard to open without the can opener, and a food processor. I'm gonna chop the onions and the garlic and I'll be right back. We're now gonna begin cooking the onions and garlic. And as you can see, the stove is set to medium. So we're gonna pour the olive oil in. So let's see how you stop. Pour faster, please. That's enough. All right, once this heats up, we'll come back and show you the process of cooking the onions and garlic. As the oil is hot, we're gonna dump the onions in to begin the cooking process. And I'll be back to show you the garlic. Guys, we're now going to begin to chop the garlic. There's about 20 cloves of garlic in there. Once we've chopped that, we're gonna add that to the onions for the cooking process, and we'll return. And as you can see, the onions are semi-see-through, and now we're gonna add a chopped garlic and cook that for another 7 minutes. I have our garlic and our onions cooked through, and we're now gonna add white wine. We're gonna let this cook for about 10 minutes because you wanna cook all of the alcohol content out of your sauce, and we'll be back. As you can see, the white wine, let me let the camera focus. The white wine has cooked down, reduced, and all alcohol content is cooked out of it. We're now going to dump our crushed tomatoes in, and that's 2 64-ounce cans. Okay, we've added both cans of 64-ounce crushed tomatoes. I'm now gonna add just a little bit of water because I don't like my sauce too chunky, nor do I like it too loose. Go ahead and stir it up, please. Okay, I'm now gonna begin adding salt. If you have larger bay leaves, you can use 2 to 3. If you have smaller ones, I always use about 6. Bay leaves. Now we're gonna add some thyme. Now I'm gonna add some basil. We're now gonna add some oregano. We're now gonna add our next week. Take a square to the top. Just laugh and get rid of that. A little bit more. Okay, and we'll now add a little bit of sugar. Because I don't like my sauce. Not bitter, not sweet, just right. Now I'll have my daughter go ahead and mix this. You have to stir really quick and really fast. Get my hand in here and mix this while my daughter grabs the top for this pan. Now you can make this a 30-minute sauce, but I can promise you it's not gonna taste the same as if you cook it for 5 to 6 hours. I like to cook mine for 5 to 6 hours because the longer you cook it, the better the flavor of the tomatoes and the better the flavor of your sauce. So I'm gonna cook this for about a couple of hours and I'll come back midway and show you the middle of the process. This is our finished marinara sauce with white wine. Once again, I like to cook mine for a total of about 8 hours. You could cook it in less time. You could even do it for 30 minutes, but it's just not going to taste the same. Usually 8 hours is better because the flavor is better because of the tomatoes cooking for that long period of time. I want to thank you guys for watching and please subscribe. And stay tuned for my next video, which is chicken parmesan.